It's an all too familiar scene for Iowa military families. Tears and hugs again tonight as more than 50 Iowa soldiers say their goodbyes to friends and family. The 649th Regional Support Unit from Cedar Rapids is headed for the war zone in Afghanistan. Welcome back, everyone. You know, the last few years we've been showing you send-off ceremonies and war updates pretty often.
But rarely do we ever get to see the high-tech training behind the scenes until tonight, when News Channel 8's Eric Hansen takes us inside the Iowa National Guard in high definition.
Since September 11th, more than 13,000 Iowans have been deployed overseas at some point. And how they prepare is more high-tech than you might imagine.
100 summers ago, when the town was named Johnston Station, soldiers first marched into Camp Dodge. But after a century, this complex is anything but creaky. In the last decade, millions have been spent here.
It was a very quiet place. We didn't have particularly tight security because there was no need for it. And after 9/11, the requirements all changed.
Warning signs scream restricted area.
The public's still allowed on Camp Dodge, but you have to have a very good reason to be here.
Because every day, bullets fly.
The more you practice, I mean, the better you get at anything you do.
But how National Guard members practice is nothing like it was even a decade ago. Weapons still fire, but the nearest range is blocks away.
Look!
In a nondescript building, real guns aim at video screens. No bullets here, just electronics. Don't mistake this for an Xbox or Wii.
In essence, yes. I mean, it's a video scenario, like a video game, but you know, we utilize it as a training tool.
Practicing with basic targets, huge launchers, and even elaborate team exercises on a fake foreign island.
It allows us to develop scenarios much like they encounter in theater.
But does pulling a trigger here make war seem too much like a game?
Everything is focused towards being able to do your real-world mission, and don't reduce it to the fact that this seems like a video game or it's simply a simulation. You got to keep in your mind that you're going to train, and how you train is exactly how you're going to go perform.
Here, normal-looking semi-trailers hold secrets. Inside, a dozen soldiers wear video headsets, working together, driving vehicles, firing weapons. This costs millions, but the Guard believes it's cheaper and better than alternatives.
Engagement Skills Trainer allows us to save valuable resources, such as ammunition and, of course, time.
But sometimes, simulators don't cut it.
This is a UH-60 Black Hawk helicopter. The UH stands for utility helicopter.
Lift off and Black Hawks can shuffle soldiers and cargo.
You dream it up, the Black Hawk can do it.
Open its doors and you can lean out feet from the Des Moines River Valley's treetops.
When these Black Hawk helicopters fly overseas, they're often extremely low. They flew about this high, is all about the trees, when they were over in Iraq recently.
The lower you fly, you stay out of sight from the bad guys. So you stay out of their line of sight so the bad guys don't see you.
Every Wednesday, these birds based in Boone fly.
To stay proficient and safe in the Black Hawk, you can't just fly it once a month.
But it takes four sets of eyes to squeeze it into a landing zone smaller than some backyards.
Clear down.
Roger that. Clear down.
Yeah, you're clear down left side.
Okay, coming down left side.
When we're sitting up here, we can't see the back of the aircraft, so we count on our crew members to be eyes on the back of the aircraft for us to help keep our rotor blades and our tail clear of any obstacles.
Got the burn high at 11 o'clock.
Roger that.
The views above Iowa or inside simulators might look cool, but this is serious. Real battles don't have do-overs.
We got to be ready.
More than 500 Iowa National Guard members are deployed overseas tonight. Another 9,000 are here at home and train every month. They don't all come to Camp Dodge every month, but since 9/11, millions have been spent there to update the facilities that prepare soldiers when they get that call.
In addition to flying, you found yourself in a few situations that would make a lot of people feel pretty claustrophobic, right?
Yeah, actually, I did. That's right. I experienced training inside a 16-ton armored vehicle that's tough outside but tiny inside. And they put me inside a Humvee and then flipped it on its top, leaving me to try to figure out how to escape from that flipped-over Humvee. Tomorrow night at 10, we will take you along for that ride and show you more of the simulations, more of the training that goes on up in Camp Dodge. It's pretty sophisticated.
It's very cool, Eric. Thank you.